Welcome to the class Advanced Data Structure and Algorithms for ME Computer Science and Engineering. The subject code is CP5151. Already we have completed Unit 1 and Unit 2. For Unit 3, I have uploaded a few video lectures in our Google Classroom, which covers the topic of from elementary graph algorithms up to strongly connected components. So this class, we are going to see what is minimum spanning tree and how to grow a minimum spanning tree and the algorithms that are helpful to draw a minimum spanning tree, that is Kruskal and Prim's algorithm that we are going to see. As usual, I am going to deliver the lecture using the material from Geeks of Geeks. Thanks to Geeks of Geeks for providing a material in an easy, understandable manner. So not only the theoretical information, but also the MCQ type of question and answer is very helpful to you. So thanks to the website who is giving those kind of stuff for understanding the concept in an easy way. First, let us introduce what is the spanning tree. What is a tree? Tree is a hierarchical data structure. Tree is a data structure that is treated as a hierarchical data structure. So in general, it comes under a linear, non-linear data structure, and it is treated as a hierarchical because this is a tree. This is a tree, and this is binary tree. So what is the difference between these two? What is the difference between these two? Can anyone say?
In binary tree, it will have only left and a single left and a right child, sir. In a tree, they will have different kind. I mean, many nodes will be there.
The similarity between both tree is there is one node that is treated as a root node. So this is treated as a root node. Root node. And here, this is treated as a root node. That is the similarity for both the tree. That is a general tree as well as binary tree. In binary tree, there is a condition imposed on the root node. Or a parent node, a root node or a parent node, that is intermediate parent node, should have a maximum of two children. One is in the left side, another one is in the right side. This is left and right. But in any case, take the case of tree, you cannot limit the number of branches. So you can have any number of branches. You can have any number of branches, and all the branches can be designated as either by number or by connections, whatever it may be. So what is the thing here is, if you drew a graph, say for example, a graph, so this graph is also treated as a non-linear data structure. And this non-linear data structure, maybe it is treated like this. And this non-linear data structure represents a topographical relationship. Topographical relationship. So this is meant for a hierarchical relationship, and this is meant for a topographical relationship. So when you take the case of a graph, when the similarity between a graph and a tree, if you could see that, what you can observe is graph can give rise to a tree. Say for example, this is a tree. If I put a connection here, then what it becomes? Lakshmi or Preeti, can anyone say? When you put a connection here, what it becomes? It becomes a graph, right?
Yes, sir.
Right. Similarly, if you cut a connection here, and if you designate one node as a root node, then what is it is? It is treated as a tree. So this is left chain, this is right chain, and for this node, this is right chain. Am I right or wrong? So
yes,
if you till this, you can find that. So this is what the similarity between a tree and a graph. Of course, there is a famous gate question is there. How many trees can be created with a graph? Or any graph can be treated as a tree. Whether any tree can be treated as a graph or not. Like that, we can. There are certain questions or there are certain statements with respect to graph and the theory. Graph and the tree. So in general, when a tree is a closed one, when a tree is a closed one, then you may treat that as a closed graph. Otherwise, it is an open graph like that. So any tree can be treated as a graph. So this is treated as a graph. This is treated as a graph, provided it is not closed, right? Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
But even then, it is also called as a tree. Even then, it is also called as a tree. So this is what that similarity between a tree and a graph. Now let me say what is a spanning tree. What is a spanning tree? Let me erase this. What is a spanning tree? So what is a spanning tree is, so given a graph, when a graph is given to you and your objective is to say, for example, a graph. This is one graph. So three node graph I have taken, and this is the label of the node A, this is B, C. The height is, distance is, weight is 5, 10, 50. Now, this is a graph. From this graph, I have to create a tree. So how to create a tree? You have to remove one branch. Just now I told, right? You have to remove one branch, because a tree should not have a closed cycle. It should be opened, and any one node should be designated as a root node. So what I can do is, I will remove this connection and make A as a root node. By having A as one root node, and I have created one graph, one tree like this. This is one tree. And the second one, by having B as a root node, left side C you have. Am I right or wrong? B left side. So I am removing this connection. Right side A I am having. Left side A. And let me have C as root node. C, if you turn this, C becomes the top. If it becomes, C becomes in the eighth position, then what is there in the left? Left is in A. Left A and right is B. Now, what is this 1, 2, 3? This 1, 2, 3 are trees. Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So from the graph, you have created three trees. Is there any other tree possible? I think no other tree is possible.
No, sir.
Yeah, yes. So from the graph, you have created three trees. This is called span. What do you mean by the word span? Span means creation. Span gives rise to. That is the real literal meaning of span. Gives rise to. So a graph of three nodes, A, B, C, with the three connection among them, is giving rise to three spanning tree. This is what the definition for spanning tree. Now, another definition we want is minimum spanning tree. That's what our title is, right? Do you have any idea what is minimum spanning tree? Either Lakshmi or Preeti?
Minimum weights.
Yeah, yes, very good. You have to substitute weights and then you have to calculate the sum of the weights. And based on the sum of the weights, you have to declare any one tree as a minimum spanning tree. That is, for a given graph, it may be possible for more than one tree. More than one tree, maybe three or four or five. But among the set of three or four trees, you have only one tree that should be declared as a minimum spanning tree. Say, for example, here the weight is A to B, 5, A to C, 10, and B to C, 15, B to A, 5. C to A 10, C to B 15, right? Now find the total cost. The cost for the tree 1 is 15, the total cost for the 2 is 20, the total cost for the C is 25. So which is having minimum total cost?
1, 3, 1. 1.
It's having the total cost of 15. So among the three spanning tree, that is created from the graph, which is treated as a minimum spanning tree, the tree one, right? So this is what minimum spanning tree concept is all about. Since it is the, since the graph given to you is a three node graph, it is easier for you to find to create the spanning tree as well as to find the minimum spanning tree. மூணு நோடு இருக்கிறனால நீங்க ஈஸியா பண்ணிடலாம் ரைட். இன் கேஸ் இந்த நம்பர் ஆஃப் நோட் இஸ் மோர், இன் கேஸ் இந்த நம்பர் ஆஃப் நோட்ஸ் இஸ் மோர், இஃப் யூ ஃபைண்ட் மோர் நம்பர் ஆஃப் நோட்ஸ் தென் தேர் இஸ் நோ ஹேண்ட் கால்குலேஷன் ப்ரொசீஜர் அண்ட் தேர் இஸ் ஐ கேனாட் சே லைக் தட் தென் த ஹேண்ட் கால்குலேஷன் வில் டேக் அ லாட் ஆஃப் டைம் கன்சம்ஷன் தென் வாட் யூ கேன் டூ இஸ் யூ கேன் கோ ஃபார் சம் அல்காரிதமிக் ப்ரொசீஜர் அல்காரிதமிக் ப்ரொசீஜர் தேர் ஆர் டூ அல்காரிதமிக் ப்ரொசீஜர் அவைலபிள் ஃபார் ஃபைண்டிங் அவுட் தி மினிமம் ஸ்பானிங் ட்ரீ. One is Kruskal, another one is Prim's algorithm. So that's what we are going to see in today's class. So I have taken the Geeks for Geeks material. First, let me explain that. Is it visible now?
Yes.
Yeah, we are going to see the Kruskal's minimum spanning tree algorithm. So it is a greedy algorithm. Why it is a greedy algorithm? Because if you are thorough with design analysis of algorithm subject, so greedy in general refers to always you are looking for a certain goal. It should be either minimize the profit, minimize the effort, or maximize the profit. That is either. So what is the thing here? Minimize the cost. So you are trying to evolve the solution, or you are trying to find out the solution whose objective is to always minimize something. So that is what it is. The group of algorithm that is whose focus is on either minimum or maximum, that kind of stuff is going to be called as greedy algorithm. So what is this algorithm is saying about? Theory part I left to you. You can read well and you can study well. Just I will explain how to create that tree. That is what is that? The algorithmic steps and everything I left to you for you to read and understand. If you are not able to understand, let me discuss in the another type of flipped classroom, right? So first, let me introduce the topic. So this is the graph given to you. This is the graph given to you. When this graph is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is the graph given to you. So now, can you draw a draw a spanning tree? See, how, first of all, you should draw a spanning tree. Then you should draw a. Then you should find a cost of each spanning tree. From the total cost, you have to calculate the. You have to find out the minimum spanning tree. That's the procedure, right? So if you have a graph like that, you should think about all the nodes. See, if you see these dashboard. I have drawn the slide. So all nodes should be there, but the edges you can omit or limit accordingly. All nodes should be there and all nodes should be connected. But if you calculate the edges of all the nodes, the edges should provide you the cost, and you should estimate the costs of all the nodes, and the final one will give you the final finally the minimum cost. Those should be triggered as the minimum spanning tree. When you this kind of tree is given, see how many nodes are there. If you look at it, there are 0 to 8, right? That are totally 9 nodes.
Nine.
So how to draw a spanning tree? You should compulsorily make sure that all the 9 nodes should be available, but the connections may be omitted based on the, and you should ensure that there should not be any closed loop. That is the second condition. There should not be any. If it is a closed loop, then it is not a tree. Do you agree with that?
Yes,
sir. So it is not a tree. It should be a graph. It might be a graph. So what you are going to draw, you are going to draw a tree. So there should not be any closed loop. So you should ensure that accordingly, either you can omit or reject edges. Otherwise, you can accept the edges. That's what the idea. So you should think about the edges. So as per the Kruskal's procedure, as per the, you can go through it later. You can easily understand. As per the Kruskal's procedure, what you should do is you should look at the graph. And you should pick the cost is minimum. Either Lakshmi or Preeti, can you say in this given graph which edge is lesser?
7 to 6
yes.
Or
1. Yes. So 7 to 6. So first, what about it? What you have to draw is you have to draw 7 to 6. Right? This is the first step. This is the first step. You should remember that when you draw, no cycle should be formed. No cycle should be formed, right? Next, what is the next small one?
6 to 5.
Yes, either you can go for 6 to 5, or you can go for
2 to 8.
Yeah, yes, or you can go for 2 to 8. Let me wait. 2T8. So what is that? Here is here in this material. Yes, they have taken 2T8. So just 2 days. So you should remember that they two are distinct. They two are distinct. They two are not connected. They two are distinct. And then you think about what is the other thing. What is the other one? Again, 6 to 5, right?
Yes, sir.
6 to 5. So again, you have to choose the 6 to 5. 6 to 5. And then you have to come back to the original tree. What is the other small one? Either 0 to 1 or 2.
Yes.
Either 0 to 1 or 1 to 5. Or 2 to 5, right? So you have to choose either 0 to 1 and 2 to 5. And then you have to do 2 to 5. Likewise, if you go one by one by choosing a minimum edge, this is the final tree. Now you remember?
Yes.
So all the nodes are available. Edges are connected. Connected all the nodes. So there is no closed cycle. There is no closed cycle or closed loop. And it is reset tree. It is reset tree. You may treat anyone as a root node. So for example, if I treat a 0 as the root node, this is left child. This is right child. For this right child, this should be either left child, and this is either left child, this is left child. For this two left child, one is 8 is as one right child, as 3 is another right child. This is left child, this is right child, and for 3, number 4 is a left child. Like that you can take. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Now if you take 2 as a root node, it has a child like 3 child, 8, 5, 3. So it is a minimum spanning tree, not a minimum spanning binary tree. So you cannot defend that. No, it should have only 2 nodes like that. So it is a minimum spanning tree only. So this is what Kruskal algorithm is all about. And if you go through the theory will also say the same thing what I discussed to you. So something else you need to do, understand some mathematical stuff with regard to the notation. That is, if it has V minus 1 edges, then what is the number of tree is possible, like that. You need to understand the thing, because they are all important for gate pattern kind of question or your MCQ type of question and answer, right? So you keep remember that, and you can go through the material that discusses the MCQ type of questions. Next, come to the Prim's algorithm. So Prim's algorithm, same tree you consider, the same tree, but what here is you should choose one node. You choose one node as a starting node. Say for example, see here I choose one node as a starting node, that is 0th node. Then I have to check from 0 where I have to go, whether I have to go 4 or I have to go 7. So as of now, I have to choose either 1. So I have to choose 4, that is 0 to 1. Then from 1 where I can go, So I have to choose accordingly. From 1 where I can go, I can go this one, 1 to 2. From 2, where I can go? One is this side, another one is this side, another one is this. So out of this, which is minimum? This is cost 2, this is cost 4, this is cost 7. Which is minimum? 2 is minimum. So this one. Likewise, after choosing this one, so you have to draw the graph by like joining dots. So whereas in Kruskal algorithm, the process is distinct. So this is one solution, one subsolution. This is another subsolution. And this is another. So whenever you form a distinct subsolution, at one point of time, all distinct solution get connected. And finally, you get the final tree. Whereas in Prim's algorithm, it is not like that. So like a rubber band stretch. So from here, I started. Then I go here. More number of higher level number of edges, I have to come here. And then I can expand here. Like that, I can proceed further. But while proceeding further, I need to remember that it should not form any cycle. It's not form any cycle. So likewise. So from this dot, I have started. So I go this way. Then I go this way. Then I go selecting this. Like that, the stuff is going on when you find a solution to for your minimum spanning tree with respect to Prim's algorithm. And if you could read the answer, sometimes if you look at the final solution, so this is final solution based on Prim's algorithm. Both the solutions are the same thing. See, 4, 0, 4, 8, 2, 4. So both have the same solution. So in majority of the situation, both the Kruskal's and Prim's algorithm give a general give a uniform solution, but there are situations where Kruskal algorithms performs better than PRIMS, and there are some situations where PRIMS algorithm better performs better than Kruskal. So this is the idea behind the PRIMS and Kruskal's algorithm in identifying the spanning tree, especially the minimum spanning tree. So with this, I close the lecture, and if you have any doubts, let us clarify.
Okay, sir.
Do you want any idea? Do you want any clarification?
No, sir.
Okay. So, have you gone through the idea further? So, I just opened the idea. You should go through further into the video. So, there are other, there are some practice questions are there. There are some codes are available. And so, code and all, not at all required. But this code and all will be required for your lab laboratory purpose. And you should always think about the time complexity. You should remember that. So time complexity of the algorithm, big O of V square or big O of E log V. So like that, you should remember the time complexity. And if you want, you can further go through the resources for Geeks for Geeks material. And you can also provided MCQ type of question answer. You can keep trying. You can attempt it. Instead of studying the theory, you can attempt the MCQ type of questions and start understanding the subject. So this is what the thing that I want to convey. Let us close this. So let's start the meeting.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.